Hi, in this video series, we will study the chapter Resources and Development. We will start with the classification of resources and then discuss the development of resources and resources planning. So let's start. What do you mean by resources? Everything that is available in our environment which can use to be satisfy our needs provided it is technically accessible, economically feasible and culturally acceptable can be termed as resource. By technologically accessible, we mean that thing can be used by humans with the present technology available. By economically feasibility, we mean the cost of production must be lower than the cost of satisfaction, which means we want to achieve. Culturally acceptable means a resource should be as per the culture and norms of the society. Nature, technology and institutions are independent on one another. Humans play key role in this relationship as they interact with nature through the help of technology and create institutions to accelerate their economic development. Thus, human beings themselves are essential components of resources. Resources can be classified in various ways, on the basis of origin as biotic and abiotic, on the basis of exhaustibility as renewable and non-renewable, on the basis of ownership as individual, community, national and international, on the basis of status of development as potential, developed, stock and reserves. Let's first distinguish resource on the basis of origin, biotic and abiotic. Biotic resources are obtained from biosphere and have life such as human beings, flora and fauna, fisheries, livestock, etc. Abiotic resources consist of all those things which are composed of non-living things are called abiotic resources. For example, rocks and metals, etc. 1. The basis of exhaustibility. Resources can be classified as renewable and non-renewable. Renewable resources are those resources which can be renewed or reproduced by physical, chemical or mechanical processes are known as renewable resources. For example, solar and wind energy, water, forest and wildlife, etc. Non-renewable resources are those resources once consumed cannot be replaced are known as non-renewable resources. These resources take millions of years in their formation. For example, oil, coal, etc. On the basis of ownership, resources can be classified as individual, community, national and international. Individual resources are those resources owned privately by individuals are called individual resources. For example, plot, houses, etc. owned by a person. Community-owned resources are resources which are accessible to all the members of the community. For example, public parks, picnic spots owned by a community. Natural resources are those resources which come under nation are known as national resources. Technically, all the resources belong to the nation. International resources are those resources lying beyond 200 kilometers of exclusive economic zone in the oceans are called international resources. No one can use these resources without the permission of international institutions. On the basis of status of development, resources can be classified as potential, developed, stock and reserves. Potential resources are those resources which are found in a region but have not been utilized. For example, the regions of Rajasthan and Gujarat have enormous potential for the development of wind and solar energy. Developed resources are those resources which are surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization. Stock are those resources that have been surveyed but cannot be used due to lack of technology. For example, water is a compound of two inflammable gases, hydrogen and oxygen, which can be used as a resource of energy but we don't have technical know-how to use them. Reserves are those resources that have been surveyed and we can use them with present technology but their use has not been started are known as reserves. For example, the water in the dams, forests, etc. After talking about the classification, now we will talk about the development of resources. It means the process of the utilization of resources. Earlier, it was believed that resources are free gifts of nature, so we exploited this without any care. This created various major problems such as depletion of resources for satisfying the greed of few individuals. Resources get accumulated in the hands of few people, which divided the human society into poor and rich. It led to the global ecological crisis such as global warming, depletion of ozone layer, environmental pollution and land degradation. To overcome these problems, we need an equal distribution of resources so we can have sustained quality of life and global peace. We are consuming resources at a very fast rate and this consumption rate is more than production rate. If this trend of consuming continued, then the future of our planet is in danger. So, we must use the resources carefully. Resources planning is a strategy of judicious use of resources which is essential for sustainable existence of all forms of life. Sustainable existence is a component of sustainable development. Sustainable development is an economic development that should take place without damaging the environment, and also the development in the present should not compromise with the needs of the future generation or upcoming generations. Resource planning is a complex process which involves identification and inventory of resources across the regions of the country. This involves surveying, mapping, and qualitative and quantitative estimation and measurement of the resources. Involving a planning structure endowed with appropriate technology, skill and institutional setup for implementing resource development plans which match the resource development plans with overall national development plans. In India, there is a vast diversity in the availability of resources. There are some regions which can be considered self-sufficient in terms of the availability of resources, and there are some regions which have the acute shortage of some vital resources. Arunachal Pradesh has abundance of water resources but lacks in infrastructural development. The state of Rajasthan is very well endowed with solar and wind energy but lacks in water resources. The cold desert of Ladakh has very rich cultural heritage but it is deficient in water, infrastructure and some vital minerals. Thus, we need balanced resources planning at the nation, state, regional and local levels. After independence, India has made concentrated efforts for achieving the goals of resource planning right from the first 5-year plan. As the resources are vital for the development and overutilization and irrational consumption of resources creates socio-economic and environmental problems. Thus, it is necessary to conserve resources. There are various measures taken to conserve resources. At the international level, the Club of Rome advocated resource conservation for the first time in a most systematic way in 1968. Subsequently, in 1974, Gandhian philosophy was once again presented by Schumacher in his book Small is Beautiful. Brundtland Commission report of 1987 introduced the concept of sustainable development that focused on the conservation of resources for the future. That's all in this video. In the upcoming video, we will talk about the land resources and the soil as a resource. We will also talk about the classification of soil and soil erosion and soil conservation. Thanks for watching the video.